Cadigan, and I want you to stay tuned for Cutaway, because here we are at Piedmont, and I got a new hairdo for this show, show number 10 on Cutaway. Watch it.
Welcome to another edition of Cutaway. I'm Brett Dixon.
And I'm Mike Williams, and we're standing in front of a very historical landmark, if I can say it in that tone of voice, the Meek Estate. Yes, it's here in Hayward, and it's quite a palace, you might say.
Exactly, and to give a little history about the Meek Estate, it was made in the 1800s by someone called Meek.
Is the guy brilliant or what? I mean, everyone, are you taking notes at home? That's the real question. Well, I think whoever did this place up really got a good deal on white paint, don't you agree?
Yeah, doesn't this place just kind of look like the cover of the telephone book, Mike?
I think we'll end it on that remark. So what do we have on the show today, Brett?
Emmett has an interview with some underground filmmakers.
One of our staff wins an award.
Simon talks to Mike about some magic.
Bill has another skate video.
I found some wild turkeys in Danville.
And we go behind the scenes of Alameda High School's TV class.
And Christy profiles director Ron Howard. So both Mike and I hope you stay with us for the next 30 minutes here on Cutaway.
And throughout the show, we're going to be here at Meek Estate in different locations. And I have to compliment you highly on the way you dressed today, Brett. You look really...
Well, thank you, Mike. And you're looking as casual as ever.
Thanks, Brett. Kind of makes me feel good.
Well, wait, the viewers are over here.
Oh, the viewers over here. And it's like a courtesy thing. So here's Vince Flory to tell you more about Cutaway.
Cutaway is a video magazine produced especially for you local cable viewers and this cable station. It's a compilation of video clips, features, some seen for the first time, and our regular Cutaway contributors. So stay tuned for another 30 minutes of Cutaway, and now for our first story, let's go back to Brett Dixon.
Hi, I'm here in front of 7-Eleven, and this is one of the closest stores to my high school, Arroyo High, here in San Lorenzo. Now, so that means that students from my school keep the store busy by patronizing it every school day. Now, is this good or bad? Should students be able to leave the campus during the school day and go and have their little break? Well, Alameda High's TV class explored this problem, and here's a short story about it that they did in 1985. Let's take a look at it.
At the start of the 1984 school year, this store has become the center of controversy between the students and school officials.
The heat is on.
Alameda High School administrators found they couldn't control the students from going to the store during class time. They enlisted the help of the campus supervisors. What is your role as campus supervisor as to students going to the store?
Trying to stop the students from going to the store.
Have you been successful in stopping them?
About 50%.
On an average day, Acme Liquors sees an estimated 200 students per day. And Mike Bradford, the owner, feels that the campus supervisors haven't really hurt business.
You know there's a controversy about the kids coming here during classes. Does this have any effect on you?
Does it have any effect on me? It slows business down a little bit. But
it slows it down?
Yeah. They have the cross guards over there to stop everybody from coming in, you know.
But I've heard that they don't do no good. Is it true?
It's shaky, you know. It goes either way. It does slow it down a little bit, but otherwise... They still come across. They wait till they leave.
It's a long stretch between the first class and lunch break, and many students find they can't handle the wait.
If you're back to class on time, there should be no problem. But if you're not back in class on time, you should get a tardy.
Going over for a snack or a Coke or whatever.
According to Vice Principal Don Sherritt of Alameda High School, students can expect the school to come down hard on them for breaking the rules.
It's a school rule. It's a school rule and actually a state law that once students are at school, they're not allowed to leave school without permission.
So the question on everyone's mind is, will this problem ever be solved?
The only time it will ever be solved is when the students understand the fact that we can't have them leaving campus without permission.
I don't really think there's anything that's going to stop anyone from going to the store.
Because if you're hungry, you're hungry, right?
That last story was produced by Alameda High's TV class on their problem with the open campus during lunchtime. And I'm still here at 7-Eleven, and I don't think it's that big of a deal for kids to come here during their nutrition break or classes or lunchtime or whatever.
Well, here I sit on this fine marble bench here at Amica State, but who knows, I may be getting over at you. I might just be like in front of JCPenney's. But this kind of verifies it. This sign that says it's like dedicated to the Cherry Land Homeowners.
1966. How do you feel about the school store situation?
Definitely. I think anytime a student wants to leave campus, get away from those rowdy teachers and just like slurp down a Slurpee. Mm-hmm. Slurp down a Slurpee. Wasn't that just kind of interesting? I like scoot. It's like a scooting thing, marble. It's kind of fun. Well, Brett, I don't know, the Slurpee, and you think we might just want to do some class there, maybe once in a while, over a Slurpee, like do some geometry over there. It's like a better setting.
No, I don't think so. You just need those in-between snacks, I think. But Mike, I think it's just about time for you to go see Simon.
And I think he's lacking imagination, really.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you really think so?
I think 7-Eleven would be the appropriate place maybe to do an art class of some sort.
No. School is for school. We don't need a store for school.
Fine. You be the judge.
Well, Mike, take off. Go to your Simon piece. I'll try to stall him here as long as I can, but you got to get over there.
All right, Brett. Okay? That's cool. All right, then, Brett. You take over, stall, do whatever you want.
Okay.
What do you... Taller. It looks more attractive.
Thanks, Mike. And next, here's Simon with his feature.
Hi, I'm Simon Kingstrom. This is my school. This is Winton Junior High, you know. I go here Monday through Friday. I hate it, but it's okay. You know, my locker rooms are over there, all that stuff. Today, I'm going to be interviewing our own Mike Williams again. He's going to be doing some magic tricks for me. He's going to make me disappear or something like that. Be ready for it. And there's Mike now. Let's go talk to him. So how's it going, Mike?
Pretty good, Simon.
You have a coloring book there.
I have a coloring book, yes. You're very perceptive, Simon.
I love coloring books.
You love coloring books?
Yeah.
I love coloring books, too. So we have something in common, and that's important on the cutaway trail.
Boys and girls at home, get your coloring books, break out your Crayolas, whatever.
Our coloring book
it needs color,
pictures
though.
In it.
But it needs color.
It needs color. This guy's really pushy, isn't he? He's kind of getting on my nerves.
You have to put color in it.
All right, colors then. Get your magic finger again and rub it all over your clothes with the color. La, la, la. Any people that just got out of the shower? Well, you're out of luck. Point it towards the book, Simon.
Say boom.
Boom. Okay. And there we have it.
It's colored. That's
it's
much better, Mike.
Book.
Took you long enough, though.
Took me long enough.
Yes.
Wasn't that fun, boys and girls? Well, I found it rather amusing. Well, I've got to get back to Amica State with Brett, but it's been fun doing this little trick for you.
Say hi to Brett.
All right, then. See you later, Simon.
Okay. Bye. He's gone. It's my show now. Well, anyways, that was my segment. I had my interview with Mike. Magic. It's all done now. Well, join me next time on my segment on Cutaway. I have some brand new stuff for you. It's going to be just perfect, you know. Just join me, okay? Thanks.
I'm Bill Strong, you're watching Cutaway, and got something new coming up, so stay tuned, all right?
I'm still here at the Amica State, and this may very well have been the site of some awards. And speaking of award ceremonies, Herb Bennett, the director of the live show, recently received the coveted Emmy for a piece that he did for KRON TV. Herb's the director, as I said, he's the director of the live show, and he's helped with a lot of pieces, maybe the Uptones, you've seen that video. He edited that. And Herb's a great guy. He's helped the show out a lot. And let's just take a look at the award ceremonies where he received his Emmy.
El Salvador Quake, Eyewitness News. Andres Alegria, editor, KPIX. The winner, Polk Street Choir, New Center Choir, Herb Bennett.
Have you ever been this nervous? Anyway, I'd like to thank Don Ford for shooting it, and I'd like to thank a lot of people at New Center for Vince Flores, John Gillette, and Don Sharp, who've given me a torch to carry, and especially my mom, Ramona, who's here tonight, who lit the torch for me. Thanks.
Congratulations, Herb. A great job. He won an Emmy. Mm-hmm. Someone from the Cutaway crew won an Emmy, and I think that's overly important, but I'm interested. I've been like thinking about it for quite a while. What would you have said if you had got that Emmy, Brett?
Oh, I don't know. Probably something defective. I'd like to thank my mom and my dad for bringing me into this world and kind of nurturing me and growing.
Okay, Brett, that's good. Kind of a typical thing in an award ceremony. I think that's what we like about Brett Dixon. Typical. Yes. Well, speaking about directors, Christy's up next, and she's got a profile on Ron Howard.
I'm here at this indoor swimming pool, and could you imagine this pool full of big rocks, like pods with alien beings growing inside of them? Well, there was a movie out last summer about that called Cocoon. And for my feature today, I have a profile of the director of that film, Ron Howard.
Yeah, and you know, as he's going like on about the fourth push, you can just kind of start to back off.
Yeah, we realize we can't get through.
Although he's only 32, Ron Howard has been in the business for 31 years.
Action! Cut! Excellent. Okay, print that.
Born into a theatrical family, he became best known for his character as Opie on The Andy Griffith Show and as Richie Cunningham on Happy Days.
Andy Griffith tells me that he remembers my saying that I wanted to be a director a long time ago. He says that my pat answer to what do you want to do when you grow up always was, I want to be an actor, writer, producer, director, cameraman, baseball player.
You should be working real hard and getting the dive equipment ready.
You
and Mike.
Ron never did become a baseball player because at the age of 15, he decided to become a film director.
I just yelled it across and everyone nodded their heads with a great deal of authority. So those who got it will explain it to those who didn't.
Following the success of his last film, Splash, Ron has finished directing his third feature film. It was the science fiction fantasy, Cocoon.
I have dreamed about this movie in one way or another just about every night since I started. So I know that the complexity of the project, that I'm really feeling it. There's a real payoff for being ambitious. And that payoff is really, I think, why everybody's in the business, or at least why I'm in the business. It's very exciting, really exciting when you meet a challenge and kind of pull it off.
Ron Howard is also directing a movie that's due out this summer. I like Cocoon and I recommend it for rental. You can get it at probably any video store. Thank you for watching me today on my segment.
Well, here we are standing in front of the Meek Estate.
Yeah.
What a fine place it is. But I don't know about old Meek. What was he thinking when he planted all these trees here? Can't even see his house. Was he ashamed of it? That's the real question. Or did he just want that privacy within?
I think we all need our little time to ourselves, that little aspect of privacy, Mike.
I agree highly. Well, Brett, what do we have up coming next, huh?
Well, we get to take a behind-the-scenes look at Alameda High's TV class. This behind-the-scenes look was done by Jeff Cohen. And by the way, you all know Alameda High's TV class because they've produced many stories for Cutaway. And so let's just go to Alameda High and check out that behind-the-scenes look.
At the beginning of 1986, United Cable of Alameda donated to the program three color studio cameras, an editor, and a complete control room. Allison Mosher and Joe Sherritt are two of the students enrolled in the program. We asked for their opinion.
I asked a lot. I think it's a real fun class. I look forward to coming to the class every day because it's kind of entertaining. You learn something new pretty much every day.
I would definitely like to get into this as a career also. I want to get into directing or possibly even editing. Maybe I can help him if he's doing a talk show or something. but I'm definitely going to go to college and pursue this as a career.
We also interviewed Arnold Luz, former student of the class, who is now attending San Francisco State University at the Video Arts.
Right now, I've learned a lot from this class. I look back here and there, what it was like and what it was back then. It was, to me, I would look at it as probably a learning experience for me.
The students of Alameda High School feel very fortunate to have TV media as a part of their educational program. Jeff Cowan reporting for Alameda High School.
I'm Emma in Piedmont, and I'd like to invite you to stay tuned to my segment of Cutaway, where I discuss films with two filmmakers, and we'll see some clips from their films coming up next in the show. Don't change the channel.
I need this job.
Don't throw your future away. Stay in school.
I'll walk, make my way through the tree, and I'm having fun, and that's the important thing. And I'm kind of analyzing this Meek estate, and I think this tree probably was the place where the Meek children hid while they were playing hide-and-go-seek. Let's just go with that theory, okay? And on today's show, we've seen a lot of TV classes and directors and such like that, and Emmett's up next. Stay on that topic, and he's got two underground directors from Piedmont, and they're going to show us some exciting clips that I'm sure you're going to be just ecstatic about seeing. So let's go to Piedmont.
Hi, I'm Emma Cadigan, and welcome to my segment of Cutaway. Here we are today in Piedmont, California, where we're going to visit with some directors, and I got a new haircut. Do you like it? I like it. And you know what my dad said? He liked it too. So everybody likes it. It's new and groovy. And we're going to talk to Evan about his film. But first, we're going to watch it, Kamala's Revenge.
Producers have determined that at this point a plot would be completely pointless. So in the interest of artistic expression, social commentary, and cheap thrills, the remainder of this film consists of nothing but senseless violence.
So that was quite an interesting little clip we saw there. What inspired you to do that, Evan?
Well, basically Sergio Leone, the guy who did The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, Once Upon a Time in the West, a bunch of other great films.
Kind of like a spaghetti western or something?
Yeah, kind of like a modern-day spaghetti western. Lots of shoot 'em up and lots of attitudes.
What are you currently doing, Evan?
I'm working on a lot of animation. Like I said, I started with animation, so I figured I'd work more on it and try to do it well. I did a little film called Mutant Thingy. This is Mutant Thingy. A little monster destroying a town. It was kind of interesting. With Super 8, you can actually do some decent animations. You can do things like this. You get a cell. You can buy this at any, like, paper supply place. You stick your drawing on it, and you do a background, and you can even do a background behind that and have another cell so things are moving. Like, in this scene, there, you're going to have a fireplace moving and a Christmas tree, and I could have the lights shine and stuff like that if I want, and have another cell with a character coming across. Things like that.
Who are your influences, Evan?
Probably my favorite director of all time is Stanley Kubrick. My taste is very divided. People kind of think it's weird. I like Amadeus and I like Friday the 13th, you know. I can see them on a double bill, you know.
Right.
It's kind of weird, but hey. And I even like Disney stuff. I could go see Pinocchio and Evil Dead and Texas Chainsaw Massacre on the same bill, you know. My reward is just seeing something done that somebody else wouldn't have done that I'd like to see. If no one else sees it, that's fine with me because, you know, I just like to try making them. The thing is, like, these days I get very motivated because there's so many films that I really hate that come out, and I'd love to see someone make something more that I would like anyway. So I just try to make films, and hopefully people like them. You know, if we're doing this thing with, like, very low budget, Super 8, anybody can do it. We're doing it with a crappy camera and all this stuff. Anyone can do it, and you just got to get out there and try and do it.
And thanks for watching my segment of Cutaway. I'd like to thank Evan for being on the show.
Well, thank you, Emmett.
And I'd like to thank Jules Worsley for his contribution. And I'd like to invite you back next week to see what we have in store, because it's always new surprises here on Cutaway. I might have a new haircut. I might have some new shoes. I might have some new videos. I don't know. Be sure to watch. Bye.
We're still here at the Meeks Estate, and look at this thing. Isn't it just like something you want to just skate? Well, I don't know where Bill is right now, but I'm sure he'd just love to come down here and just like skate this ramp, maybe do a couple jumps. Mike!
Brett!
How you doing?
Pretty good.
What are you doing down there?
I'm just down there checking out the Meeks wine cellar, and I have to compliment them highly.
choice selection of wines.
Vintage, you might call it.
He's got a better vocabulary than I. I don't care, though. Up next, we have Bill Strong. He's our skate reporter, and we'll check out his feature now. Welcome to my segment. Today, we have some vert skating, that's ramp, and it was filmed by John Burton. Goes to Alameda High, and the ramp's in Alameda. I'm sure if you watch Cutaway, you remember the Blood Bowl piece? Yeah, he filmed that. And I don't know, I think this is better anyway. They're both good. So let's check it out. That was good. Ramp skating. That again was filmed by John Burton. Vert skating. I liked it. That's pretty good. And next week I'll be back with some skimboarding. So until then, I'll catch you guys later, alright? Now we're off to the suburbs, to Danville, where Brett has found some wild turkeys.
Here we are in a quiet, plush neighborhood. Now, doesn't this remind you of a Steven Spielberg set like Poltergeist or E.T.? Well, what if this quiet suburban area was overrun by wild turkeys? Well, in Danville, California, turkey droppings were sighted and the attack mounted. Yeah, that's right. This plush neighborhood in Danville is the victim of some menacing wild turkeys.
Nothing dull in Danville.
Reporter John Fulmer from KRN-TV got this reaction from Terry Anderson.
Did they get on your house?
Yes, and they sound like a herd of elephants. Yes, they're huge.
They get on your house and parade around? Or?
They'll fly up on the roof sometimes. And one morning, they were up on my neighbor's roof, and we could hear them gobbling.
And some of the neighborhood kids say that the turkeys are rude.
Yeah, they walk up to your glass sliding your door, and they go...
And look at you?
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
It's weird.
Over at the local school, near the field where the turkeys were seen, the kids have fun describing the gobblers. The SPCA says that they are wild and would probably not cause too much harm.
They have been interesting, but they've been around for so long, we're kind of tired of them.
Well, here I am, still at Mika State in front of the historical fountain. Kind of like not running right now, but that's okay. But I'm kind of insecure because Brett's not here. I don't know. A hand, another hand, and a head. It's like a creep show thing, don't you agree? And here he comes in a very awkward position. How you feeling, Brett?
Pretty good.
Have a nice swim?
Fun. Yeah, it's been great fun.
That's good. How do you think the show's going, Brett?
Oh, I think it's going pretty good. So, Mike, it looks like some people have been riding here us here at Cutaway.
Definitely. Here's a letter from Stephanie that wrote that she's a true Cutaway addict. And she claims she's serious, and she tapes the show every week and watches them 3 times during the week. And she thinks she's weird for doing this. And I'd like to say, well, actually, we can both say it.
You're not weird.
Definitely. You're not weird for watching
it
3 times a week.
It's perfectly normal. We've taken a poll.
Yes, definitely. And here's another letter from Heidi that you guys should definitely see this. She's got kind of psychedelic, really creative.
60-ish. I like it.
I like it a lot. And I'm telling
my outfit.
You're grasping here, Brad.
I am.
You're
but I'm having fun.
That's the important thing.
And we'd like to say that we're talking about letters here. And we'd like to say that if you'd like to write me or you, Mike.
Mike. My name is Mike, and I deserve letters because Brett seems to get them all.
No, that's not true, Mike. But anyway, if you'd like to write either one of us or any of our contributors,
here's Vince Flory to tell you the address to write both of us or anyone on the Cutaway staff.
Take it away, Vince.
Thanks, Mike and Brett. It's time to get your pencil out. As they suggested, here's the address. You can write any of the staff, Mike, Brett, Christy, Emmett, Simon, Bill, or even Tim. The address is here, 1666 Redwood Avenue, San Leandro, California, 94579. They'll write you back as soon as you get a letter, and we'll send you out some program schedules and other items about Cutaway. We'd also like to suggest that you send us some comments and story ideas to that same address. One more time, 1666 Redwood Avenue in San Leandro, California. Next time on Cutaway, Bill Strong has a story about skimboarding at Alameda Beach. And Emmett takes us on a journey through a cemetery. That's all next time on Cutaway. But for now, let's join Mike and Brett back to close this edition.
I guess it's time to close another edition of Cutaway, Mike.
Right.
We've had a lot of fun here. We've gone to the Meek Estate, and we're at the playground.
We're at the playground, and it's kind of
fun.
Sums it up, because it's like the childhood, reliving the childhood, you might say.
And there's lots of children here. It's a great place to have a barbecue, bring
just
your family.
Hang out, even have a wedding, because the hors d'oeuvres at weddings are really good. I find that. I don't know about yourself, but I like weddings.
So, Mike, what do you have planned for the next show?
Well, we're going to have all our regular... it's a Max Headroom thing again. I'm sorry. It's just one of those modes I fall into. All our regular contributors, Tim, Emmett, Christy, and both Brett and myself are going to all be here, and should be a lot of fun. So look for that.
Definitely. So let's just wrap it up now by saying, for Cutaway, I'm Brett Dixon.
And I'm Mike Williams. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
We're having fun. It's a wrap.
I love the sand. Don't you love sand?
I love it too, and it's a great show.
It's
Cutaway. Forever.
How do you feel like being on Brett and Mike's rap?
Well, it's a great experience. I'd like to thank all the little people like Mike here.
Like Mike, he's talking to me. Little people, look at you. Glad I took
you
my
had to take the shoes off, didn't you?
Yes. You mind like carrying them for me? I abuse them. I'm sorry. So Mike, who are you taking to junior prom?
Thanks.
You got a date yet? Yeah, I do. Okay, I do.
Who?
So you gonna skate home or what? Do you want to drive? More than a day. It's been a day plus an afternoon and coming on evening, so it's like an algebra problem, you might say. It's like math. And here's the car. Wait, you want to go home?
Yeah.
You tired?
I'm tired. Let's go home.
Okay, let's go home.